Okay, now we have to see our salt palate. So salt palate is just a muscular flap. It's just a muscular flap. Okay, muscular flap like organ. Okay, so it is actually hanging down from the posterior border of our heart palate. Okay, so it is hanging down from the posterior border of our heart palate. Okay, in the pharyngeal cavity, that is your oropharynx. Okay, pharyngeal cavity like a curtain. Parda you have seen. So that parda is just like it is like, just like a parda in the posterior side of our oral cavity, or it's just like a anterior wall for our oropharynx. Okay, the pharyngeal cavity. So curtain we can say, or in Latin we say it as velum. Okay, so this is actually a soft palate. It's a muscular flap, muscular organ, which is formed by duplication layer of our mucous membrane, duplication layer of mucous membrane, and of our palatine aponeurosis. Okay, palatine aponeurosis. This much is clear. Now, what are the surfaces actually for this soft palate? So surfaces. So in the case of surfaces, we have actually two surfaces. We have first of all oral surface, or we can say it as anterior surface. Oral surface. Which is actually forming, which is attached to the posterior border of our heart palate. Okay, so you can see it in this sagittal diagram. Here you can see this dotted one. You can see this is a hard bony palate. Okay, this is sagittal section. This is a nasal cavity. This is your tongue and above tongue, and between the nasal cavity there is a palate. Okay, so heart palate is just this much area. This is just a lateral line. You can see this is the end of our heart palate. After that, your soft palate begins. Okay, so this much area is your soft palate. So now you can see this anterior border. This one is your anterior border. It is attached to our posterior border of our heart palate. Okay, so you can see this is a heart palate and this is your soft palate. Okay, so that is why it is called as oral surface. So first surface is oral surface. Now second surface is posterior surface. And this posterior surface is actually attached. That is its continuation with the floor of nasal cavity. You can see this is your actually nasal cavity above this, and this is your actually posterior surface. This much area is your posterior surface, and it is forming the floor. This is the roof for nasal cavity, this area, and this is the floor. So it is this posterior surface is forming the floor for our continuous with floor of nasal cavity. This much you can say. Okay, now it has two borders actually. So first border is superior border. So superior border is actually attached to our hard bony palate. Okay, you can see this one superior border. This one is actually superior border, and it is actually con. Now the superior border, you can see. So superior border is actually attached to the posterior border of heart palate. Posterior border of heart palate. Okay, so you can see in the sagittal diagram. So the superior border, upper border, this line you can see, this is actually superior border, and it is attached with the posterior border with the heart palate. Okay, so so these two, hard and soft palate, has a connection here. Now the second border is inferior border. So inferior border here, it is actually free. Okay, so inferior border here actually free, and this border actually forms the anterior boundary for our pharyngeal isthmus, that is fauces. Okay, and it is free, and when this border actually ends, it forms a small conical like projection, which we say it as uvula. Okay, it has a tongue like projection, small tongue like projection. If we ask about the shape, it is just like a small tongue-like projection. Okay, small conical-like projection. It is just the ending of our inferior border. In this diagram, you can see. So this is actually the that is your inferior border. Okay, so this below one, and it is ending here in the oropharynx. Okay, so this is forming actually, this area is actually your uvula. So this part is actually your uvula. Okay, conical like projection or tongue like projection here, small. And below that there is fauces, just the posterior side of your tongue. We can see here is the fauces or pharyngeal isthmus. So pharyngeal isthmus, because of pharyngeal isthmus, it is forming the anterior boundary for this fauces, this uvula. Okay, so uvula, now uvula has actually on each side of uvula we have two arches. Okay, on each side of uvula we have two arches, arcs. Okay, on each side of we have arches. So first arch is, arc is actually your palatoglossal arc. So it is actually consists of palatoglossal muscle. This is a muscle for our, this is a soft palate muscle. Okay, palatoglossal muscle, and it is coming from the lateral side and forming your lateral boundary for the sides of tongues and attaching the sides of tongue and ending in the lateral side. Okay, so this is the anterior arc, you can say. This is present anteriorly, so you can say it like anterior pillar for your soft soft palate. Okay, now second comes your palatopharyngeal arc. And this arc actually is called as posterior pillar. Okay, posterior pillar or posterior arc. Okay, it's just posterior. It also goes some parts of lateral, and then it forms the actually the anterior boundary for our pharyngeal cavity in the posterior side. Okay, so it consists of actually palatopharyngeal muscle. This is another muscle of our soft palate. So we'll be seeing the video on muscles of soft palate in the next. Okay, and this is only the anatomy for our soft and hard palate. So it is forming the posterior pillar. Okay, so you can see this, just like I'm showing the structure. So just consider this is as your posterior side, and this is uvula, and just lateral to that there are pillars. Okay, so you can see this one is your anterior pillars. Okay, the most lateral it will be, and just below that there will be your posterior pillar like this. Okay. So this one is your anterior pillar, and this one is your posterior pillar. Palatopharyngeal arc, and this is your anterior pillar. And between them, there is a tonsillar fossa. So between these two pillars, we have a fossa, tonsillar fossa. So in between them, that is, this space is actually called as tonsillar fossa. Tonsillar fossa. We have seen in this diagram, you have seen the oral cavity. So you can see this is the uvula, and between this is your anterior pillar, this is a posterior pillar. Okay. Posterior pillar. Okay, now between them you can see this one is your anterior pillar, that is your palatoglossal arc, and this is your palatopharyngeal arc, and between them there is a tonsillar fossa, this space. Okay, and between them there is a tonsil, that is the tissue of our lymphoid tissue, which is called as palatine tonsil. Okay, so the space is actually called as tonsillar fossa, and it consists of palatine tonsil. Okay, made up of lymphoid tissue. Okay, so these two arches are actually present on the each side of our uvula. Okay, like this they forms a pillar. One forms from the anterior side and one from the posterior side. The posterior one is called as palatopharyngeal because it has attachment with the pharyngeal cavity, so that is why its name is pharynx. And palatoglossal because it has attachment with the sides of the tongue, so it has an attachment with the palate and plus with the tongues. And these two muscles are the muscles of our soft palate. Okay, extrinsic muscles of soft palate. We'll be discussing these muscles in the next video. Okay, in the next topic, that is muscles of soft palate. Okay, so this was the anatomy for our actually for this hard and soft palate. Okay, so thank you. Do like, share and subscribe the channel.